Welcome to ElevenLabs Agents Academy. In this video series, we will get you started building agents in just a few minutes, taking you from the very beginning to your first conversational agent, covering advanced use cases like testing and simulation, adding your first knowledge base, integrating your agent into your website, your mobile apps, and your telephony workflows. And also look at advanced use cases like webhook and post-call processing and analysis. Throughout this course, you can choose which path you want to take. You can get started with the ElevenLabs Agents platform through the ElevenLabs app without writing any code, or you can use the CLI as well as our SDKs to jump straight into the code. Whatever flavor you prefer, you can choose how you want to go along. At the end of this series, you will have production-grade conversational agents at your fingertips, and we can't wait to hear how you will deploy them. Now, let's get started building your very first agent. Trust me, it really just takes a couple of minutes. If you haven't already, sign up for your ElevenLabs account and you will enter the agent's platform. The first time around, you'll be prompted to create your first agent. You can choose one of the templates that are available. Let's say we want to build a customer service agent for our business. So we'll just choose the business agent here. We can define kind of our category. So say we have, you know, an e-commerce store and we want to build an agent for our customers to help them, you know, track their orders, maybe open a return and, you know, kind of all the things that customers might want to do. So we'll choose the retail category here. And then we'll want to make this a customer support agent. So basically for inbound customer queries, but we could also actively, you know, use it for customers when they're, you know, kind of starting with their order. So let's just go ahead and call this our store assistant. We can optionally put in our website here. So what this will do is actually help you kind of scrape information from your website and allow you to get started even faster. But so let's just say you're a customer support assistant helping customers find their orders and answer any questions they might have. Okay, let's just start here. We can always refine it later on. So now ElevenLabs will go ahead and configure our first conversational agent for us. As you can see, we didn't have to write any code. It really just took a minute to define this. And now we can see a couple of configuration options that we have available here. So first of all, we can set the agent language. So this is the default language that we want our agent to have. We can choose from many different languages that are available, and we can also make our agent multilingual very, very easily. So for example, if we are building for, you know, kind of customers across America, we might want to add Spanish as an additional language. So we can just come in here and find Spanish. We can enable that. Maybe also we want to enable Portuguese for our customers in Brazil. So what we can do now is we can also enable language detection for optimal switching between languages. So in most use cases, you probably want that. And what this does is it enables our system tool to automatically identify if the customer is speaking in a different language and then switch to that supported language. So what you can see here is we created a first message for you that just says, "Hi there, I can help you track your order and answer any questions you might have." So we can also translate this into the additional languages. So first of all, let's take a moment here and save the changes that we made. And so we can now see here that these are all already translated into our different languages. So you can see here,
that's translated already into Portuguese as well as Spanish. Fantastic. So now our agent is pretty much already ready to speak. Another key component of your agent is the system prompt. The system prompt is used to determine the persona or personality of your agent and kind of sets the parameters of how your agent will react. So there are certain best practices to encoding and adding guardrails to the persona of your agent. So for example, you can add in a personality, so your customer support assistant for retail business, friendly, helpful, efficient, you assist customers in finding their orders. You can set the environment. You're assisting customers over the phone or on the website. Furthermore, you can encode the tone. The goal setting is also a good section to have. You can maybe encode kind of a sequence that you want the agent to take, sort of how to react to certain situations, problem resolution. And then guardrails is an important factor as well to make sure the agent kind of acts within that persona you want it to have. So for certain businesses, you want it to be more serious. In other scenarios, you might want it to be a bit more friendly and maybe kind of small talky, chatting with folks. So these things you can encode in the guardrails as well. I will add some documentation for you to go through after this video, which will help you kind of with the best practices and getting started with your system prompt, as well as kind of the voice design to really get the agent to behave and sound like you want it to. Another component, and we'll look at this in a later section, are dynamic variables. So if you, for example, have an application or a website where the user is logged in and you know their name and maybe their customer ID or their location, things like that, you can dynamically inject these variables into your application. Now, another core component to your agent is the large language model. So this acts as the brain for your agent. A key feature to the ElevenLabs Agents platform is that you can practically choose any LLM that you want. You can even go as far as training your own LLM and hosting that and putting it in as a custom LLM, which we'll cover at a later section as well. For now, we'll just get started with Gemini 2.0 Flash, which is one of the most cost-efficient options for the brain of your agent. The temperature and these additional settings we will kind of latch untouched for now. We'll dive into that later. The agent knowledge base and RAG we will cover in a later section as well. Let's have a look at the tools. I mentioned earlier that we have a system tool available to detect the language. So as you can see earlier, we opted into the language detection tooling. So what that did is it enabled this detect language system tool, which we can also configure here if we want to. So we could, for example, add a prompt that we want to customize if we wanted to, influence kind of the language detection in a certain way. Otherwise, you can leave it blank. And that's the great thing with the ElevenLabs Agents platform, is that we will have very, very good defaults for you that you can customize if you need to. But you can just leave that blank to get started initially. And the custom MCP server option we'll cover in a later advanced section as well, or as well as kind of the workspace auth connections. So really just within a couple of minutes, we can get started and maybe we can just at this point, have a talk to our agent here. So within the test agent section, we can initiate a call. We can switch between the languages, but we also have the call detection, the language detection tool enabled. So now if we go ahead.
Hi there, I can help you track your order or answer questions you might have.
That's great. Can we also talk in Spanish, please?
Hola. Claro que sí, a partir de ahora podemos hablar en español. ¿En qué puedo ayudarte hoy?
Fantastic. So as you can see, we can chat with our agent
It is pretty much ready to go, which is fantastic. As you can see here, we also had a chat component. So this agent has multiple modalities that we can use. We can use the voice, we can use the chat for certain information. It's easier to use the chat, for example, to use the text modality. You know, email addresses, for example, can be quite difficult to dictate to a voice agent. So in that case, you could integrate the chat component into your agent as well. Okay, great. So we managed to configure our first agent. Now we can go back and look at some of the more advanced configurations. As I mentioned, the system prompt is crucial to defining the persona of your agent. We've put together this best practices prompting guide, which will walk you through the six different building blocks of the system prompt that can help you really nail down the persona of your agent and get it to behave in just the way you want it to. Another crucial component for our agent is the voice. Now, this is where ElevenLabs really shines. We have an entire voice library of thousands of different voices, so you can find the perfect one with the ideal tone as well as accent for your users. So you can see here, we've predefined Eric as the default voice, but you can go in and you can customize voices. You can pick them from the voice library. So for example, if we want kind of an female American accent, casual conversational voice like Rachel, we can just choose Rachel here, and literally we just have to click save and our agent is updated. Now, we've tested the agent already and, you know, it's great. It could converse. It was backed by Gemini 2.0 Flash as the brain, but so far it doesn't have any knowledge about our business. So here in the agent section, we can scroll down to the agent knowledge base. The easiest way to get started is to add a document URL. We can also insert text or add files that we want to be available. But the easiest way is we just pass in a URL. So for example, we have some information here about prompting best practices. So if we want our agent to know about this, we can simply put in the URL here and add that in. So in the background, what will happen is that we will scrape the information from this website, and we will make that available to the agent. So as you can see, this document will then be made available to the agent in its entirety. So what we can do as well is we can enable RAG, so we can break it down into embeddings and perform kind of this similarity search, which is a bit more of an advanced topic that we can dive into later. But for now, we will not do that. We'll just put in the entire document. Now, as I mentioned as well, this conversational voice design is also very important. So we can make that information available to our agent as well. And again, we can just add in the URL. Now, all this functionality and configuration for the agent is, of course, also available via the API. So you can actually create as well as update agents right here from the API. So for example, if you wanted to add in new knowledge base documents, you can create a knowledge base document, for example, from a URL or from a text file. You can generate kind of RAG indexes for it as well. And then you can attach these knowledge bases to your agent. So everything you see in the dashboard, that can be configured via the application. You can also configure through the API. Okay, fantastic. So now our agent has some specific knowledge about our business. So we can go back again and let's have another test call, this time with Rachel, as well as the editing knowledge base.
Hi there. I can help you track your order or answer questions you might have.
I was wondering, what are the six building blocks for the perfect system prompt?
Certainly. The six building blocks for the perfect system prompt are personality, environment, tone, goal, guardrails, and tools. Would you like me to elaborate on any of these?
Yeah, what are sort of the guardrails?
Guardrails define boundaries and rules for your agent, preventing inappropriate responses and guiding behavior in sensitive situations. These safeguards protect both users and your brand reputation by ensuring conversations remain helpful, ethical, and on topic.
There we go. So this is really how easy it is to get up and running with your very first agent using the ElevenLabs Agents platform. Try it out and also check out the best practice guides for designing your system prompt as well as the conversational voice design. And check out the other videos to learn how you can now take your new agent and bring it into your website, configure it for your telephony use cases, or add it to your native mobile apps. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.